We have lots of people here today that are concerned about the actions of the Fiscal Management Control Board that's being proposed for 2 weeks from now. We're here today to stand together against the proposed cuts to the MBTA. The MBTA is an essential service here in Boston. The MBTA is an essential service in Greater Boston. The MBTA is an essential service in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Their budget challenges are real and significant, but moving forward with these service cuts, especially right now, hurts our residents and is short-sighted. It will hurt our city's ability to recover from this pandemic. It will create lasting impacts for years to come for so many different constituencies and so many different businesses here in the city of Boston. We're at a turning point right now in our nation. We'll soon have a new partner in Washington who's actually talking about a federal stimulus package. There's progress on the current federal funding for transit, which may make the proposed cuts unnecessary. With the recent developments on the COVID-19 vaccines, we could see, and we will see, an increase in ridership soon. With all these changes, we cannot rush this decision. These cuts would hurt low-income workers the wrong way. It ends subway service for late-night workers, people who do not own a car, who can come into work. That impacts our essential workers as well, who are keeping our city running and don't have an option to working from home. The cuts that are being proposed would hurt our residents with disabilities, and that's wrong. Our most vulnerable members of our society might not have cars or anyone to drive them where they need to go. These cuts would hurt our veterans from their health care in the middle of a pandemic, and that's wrong. Those proposed cuts on the E-Line service to Mission Hill and the VA hospital. More than 30% of the veterans that the VA serves relies on the MBTA. We're joined today also by our Commissioner of Veterans Affairs, John Santiago. The VA is always also providing COVID testing for our veterans, where our veterans go to get tested. We're giving one message to go get tested, and the MBTA is sending another message saying we're not going to take you there. Councilor Bach and Councilor Flynn have been advocating against cutting the E-Line service from the very beginning. Councilor Flynn works with the Disabled American Veterans Group, who are concerned about these cuts. I mentioned Councilor Santiago, I call him John, Rob Santiago. He knows how much our veterans across our country depend on public transit. Today, I want to remind everyone, today is Pearl Harbor Day. It's a day when we remember the sacrifice of the brave men and women who served our country. They deserve our gratitude, not a reduction in the service that they rely on every day. These cuts would hurt our public health and our climate. It would cause more crowded bus and trains, increase the risk of spreading COVID-19. These cuts would ultimately hurt our recovery from COVID-19. A recent public transit public goods coalition study made up of transit workers and riders across the Commonwealth estimates that these cuts would threaten more than 800 jobs. We don't need to cut jobs, we need to add jobs at this particular moment. These cuts would move the goal line further down. The bottom line here is that these cuts are just simply wrong. They would hurt workers, they would discourage ridership, they would slow our recovery, they'd create a bigger problem down the road. And many people said, where do you make up for the money? Be creative. Look at your budgets. I was in the legislature in 1997, and there was three times where we had to make drastic cuts. In this particular case, it's not even about raising revenue at this particular moment because the ridership is not there. It's about realigning our priorities. Here in our city budget, the city council this year and myself, we cut $65 million out of the budget. We're able to look at our debt and realign some of our debt and make some cuts and put some hiring freezes in place. We're looking at if we have to make some decisions as we further go along the road. Our first instinct's not going to be to cut, lay off in public works, lay off in parks and recreation, lay off in transportation. That's not the first instinct. So I'm asking and I'm demanding that the Fiscal Management Review Board go back, sit down with the legislature, and come up with a plan that's an equitable plan that works all along. Cutting MBTA service will set us back further in the Commonwealth.